We'll share something from the Rambam as it relates to Tzomot and Taniyot, the days of fasting. The Rambam, in the beginning of the laws of Taniyot, says it's a mitzvah taseh min haTorah. It is a positive commandment, a biblical positive commandment, lizok ulehariya b'chatzotot al kol tzara shetavo al hatzibur, to call out, to recite supplications, and to scream out and cry out to Hashem on any calamity or trouble that happens to the wider public. And there are psukim that the Rambam learns from that. And he says, V'davar zeh midarkei hatshuva hu. This is from or associated to the ways of teshuvah. How is it that when we have war, we're connected to teshuvah? War, you got to go to war, make sure you have ammo and tactical way, and you go. But for Am Yisrael, there's a dual premise. One is that we're proactive, we go, we make sure we have ways to defeat our enemies, but also we also associate that and we don't break the link in understanding that it's also connected to Hashem, because our life is always connected to Hashem. Even in the most unexpected places, it's connected to HaKadosh Baruch Hu guiding us, delivering good things to us, and giving us a message how He wants us to graduate ourselves, to grow and become better and closer and wiser about our actions and our choices, because everything is about choices. Everything is about actions. Everything is about decisions. What I decide to do today, how I decide to respond, how I decide to create my day, create my family, and become the person that I want to become in alignment with the Torah. And therefore, even when a war happens, instead of blaming and pointing fingers and going all different directions, we look inside internally, and then we also make practical and tactical moves. And that is when we have any calamities. How is that also connected to the days that we're now approaching? We're approaching the days, the 9 days, now we're in the 3 weeks that we remember the great loss of Jerusalem. And the Rambam says, when it comes to remembering the loss of Jerusalem, just like then, Jerusalem was destroyed because of improper behavior, whether it was really bad things like stealing and killing and things like that, or it was things that may not seem so terrible, but they're really bad and they prolong within society, which is baseless hatred, sinat chinam. Those things were maybe the back end problems that led to the destruction of Jerusalem and of the temple. The destruction of the temple is so sincere and dire to us, even though so many years passed. The Rambam brings halachot that when a person comes and sees Yerushalayim b'chorbanah, he sees Jerusalem destroyed, they tear their clothing. If you leave and you come back after 30 days, you tear your clothing again. It depends where you come from. If you see the Temple Mount or Jerusalem destroyed, you may have to tear twice, depending which area you come from. It's not simple. And therefore, in the days of Tisha B'Av, as we connect to the idea that we're connected to the land, we're connected to the blessing in the world, also the days of Tisha B'Av today, as we're approaching the 9 days especially, we have certain requirements in halachot that allow us to connect more to the idea. And when we practice them, kol hamitabel al Yerushalayim, anyone that mourns over the loss of Jerusalem, which has many layers of understanding to it, zoche v'ro'eh besimchata, will merit to see in the happy and joyous moments of rebuilding Yerushalayim. So we're all always connected to the Holy Land, always connected to Yerushalayim, and always trying to figure out what it is that Hashem wants us to do now, so that we can have better days and better outcomes. And therefore, now that we're approaching the days of the 9 days, there's a minhag, says the Rambam, not to eat, some have the minhag not to eat meat and drink wine on the week of Tisha B'Av. Some have a minhag of not doing so from the beginning of the 9 days. The question is if it's including Rosh Chodesh or not. And if you look at the Shulchan Aruch, they even bring that some do it from Yudayin B'Tammuz. We do not have that practice. And therefore, when it comes to meat and wine, those that already have the long-standing practice of not eating meat or drinking wine from Rosh Chodesh, or if you will, a day after Rosh Chodesh, that begins, Rosh Chodesh is on Monday, so therefore, that begins, if you want to say it after Rosh Chodesh, that begins Monday night, and Tuesday, we don't eat meat or drink wine. Of course, on Shabbat, in between, we do. And the idea is not about the meat or the wine, the idea is that it allows us to understand the days that we're in and the future outcomes that we want to retain. As the Rambam says, La'atid lavon, when redemption will arrive, all these worries are going to be behind us. It's going to be our history. These days are going to turn into days of simcha, they're going to turn into days of happiness and joy, as it says in the Rambam, the last halacha in Hilchot Taaniyot, kol atzmot ha'elu atidim libatel imot ha'mashiach. We're no longer going to have to fast for any of these issues. And not only that, they're going to turn into days of yamim tovim v'simcha. And he brings the pasuk that these days, soma revi, soma chamishi, soma shevi'i, v'soma asi'i, yeh levet yehuda l'sason v'simcha, ולמועדים טובים והאמת והשלום אהבו, ברוך ה' לעולם.
אמן ואמן, ברוך הבא.